Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the diabetescouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Now, I want to emphasize that my perspective is coming from one with type 2 and not type 1 diabetes. Our channel is primarily targeted for those with type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. Today, I want to answer your question, what is A1C? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you can find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. As a person with diabetes or pre-diabetes, there are certain terms and tools we all need to know about in order to help keep our blood sugar under control. One of those terms is A1C. Now, A1C is used to diagnose diabetes and used as an indicator to help manage diabetes. The A1C test is a blood test that provides information about a person's average levels of blood glucose, also called blood sugar, over the past 3 months. The A1C test is sometimes called the hemoglobin A1C, the HbA1C, or the glycohemoglobin test. Specifically, the A1 test measures the percentage of your hemoglobin that is coated with sugar. Hemoglobin is a protein in red blood cells that carries oxygen. If you have a high A1C, then you aren't controlling your blood sugar very well, and this has the potential to cause more related problems. Where the A1C is better indicated is how you are controlling your blood sugar over simply testing once or twice a week. Is that the A1C looks at your average blood glucose level over that 3 month period. Now, you may take your levels at the same time each day, say as soon as you get out of bed. Your blood sugar reading may be 120 or even better, but as the day goes on, your levels may increase with the consumption of meals, lack of exercise, and other factors. Now, you're under the impression that you have a good control on your diabetes when in reality, you really may not. The A1C number is a percentage of the average blood glucose level. It is measured in milligrams per deciliter. For someone without diabetes, their A1C should be 5.7 or below. When the A1C test is used to diagnose diabetes, an A1C level of 6.5 or higher on two different tests yields a diagnosis of diabetes. A result between 5.7 and 6.4 gives a diagnosis of pre-diabetes. This just means you have a higher risk of developing diabetes. Now, if you have diabetes, your healthcare provider will more than likely give you a goal to reach concerning your A1C. Usually, 7 is considered a good A1C for someone with type 2 diabetes. If you have pre-diabetes, well, then your goal should be 5.7. A good way to think of your A1C is a tool in your diabetes arsenal to help you control and improve your diabetes care habits. This information will hopefully help you stay focused to reach your goals in your diabetes self-care. Don't forget to get my new ebook and please subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this one in the future. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.